in participating, they can pick up their registration applications for their teams, and they can pick them up at any Carnicería La Noria locations.
So that's soccer, right?
It's going to be, it's a soccer tournament. It's a two-day event. You know, it doesn't matter what league they play with, if they play with American, you know, indoor, outdoor soccer. It will be an outdoor soccer event, and it's going to be with food, entertainment. It's going to be an event for the whole family to attend.
Interesting. I haven't been to one yet, so I'd love to be there. I love soccer. Well, I love to see the players playing soccer, right? Because I just love their techniques and how they, you know, handle the ball and all that. But that's great. So you're one of the organizers of that event. That's amazing.
Yes, you know, we have been doing it in years prior, but it was always indoor. This is our first year that we're taking it outdoor. Yeah. And so we hope to have a lot of success.
Well, that's great. We definitely need to be there. Mm-hmm. Now tell us a little bit, how's the magazine going?
It's going actually really great. Thank you guys for following us. If you guys, I'm going to invite you guys to like us on our Facebook page. It's the Studies on the Magazine. Mm-hmm. Every month we're going to be giving away different prizes. This month we're going to be giving away Sakura tickets. So, and we will be announcing them online.
By the way, I have to go and eat there. I heard the food is good.
It's delicious.
It's delicious? What is it that you like over there that is
I like good? Everything. I like the seared salmon. I like the spicy tuna, spicy yellowtail. I like the whole menu.
Well, I gotta go there as well. Well, thank you so much for being here, Vanessa. I really appreciate it. And by the way, thank you so much for bringing your beautiful kids on the December show. They did, I mean, I don't know if you guys saw her daughter. She really looked like Virgin Mary. I mean, she was so beautiful, innocent, and serious. I mean, she was, I mean, all proper on the camera. Mm-hmm. And your boy, by the way, hi. Thank you for taking the photos. But anyway, so any other thing that you want to add for our, you know, viewers?
Just if you guys want to pick up our magazines, you guys can also get them at the Booth Mobile, different locations at the Food Cities. They're free for you, and we hope you like it's a new concept, and it's for the community, and hopefully you guys like it.
Well, good. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And I like that, you know, you go over and do community events and support them as well. Mm-hmm. I think that it's important to support as many as we can. Everybody does, and we need to do it. But thank you so much for being here, and we'll see you soon, right?
Yes, thank you.
Y bueno, amigos, continuamos con Bienvenidos a su casa, y recuerden que la diversión empieza aquí. Y bueno, amigos, bienvenidos a su casa de nuevo. Este ha sido un programa fabuloso, como verán ustedes, lleno de arte, de entretenimiento, de talento, de todo. Ustedes no se imaginan y estamos muy, muy orgullosas esta vez de también presentar de nuevo a nuestro querido amigo Arturo Valenzuela, diseñador, artista. Bueno, ¿qué le puedo decir? Un montonón de cosas que ahorita nos va a platicar. Y tenemos también a los artistas Roberto Bejarano y Sergio Tamayo. Enseguida vamos a platicar un poquito con ellos. Pero bueno, bienvenidos a todos. ¿Cómo están?
Muy bien, muy bien. Aquí estamos para servirle.
Gracias, María, por la invitación una vez más. Pero esta vez pensamos que siempre ha sido, ¿verdad?, un agasajo estar aquí con usted. Gracias. Pero esta ocasión yo vengo con este par de galanes que son grandes amigos y compañeros en el Artes Plásticas que vienen de aquí del estado de Sonora. Así es que estamos, de hecho, abriendo y cerrando. Bueno, cerramos el año con el señor Bejarano, con su obra, pero ahora lo estamos abriendo con el señor Tamayo, precisamente el día de hoy, 24 de enero, ahí en Main Gate Square, en la Plaza Jerónimo, en la Galería Jerónimo, con la obra del señor Tamayo, que me gustaría que él también que nos dijera un poco de esa obra, y pues que nos acompañen hoy. Es el 800 al este de la University Boulevard, de la Euclid University, en Main Gate Square.
Perfecto, vamos a estar ahí. Pues muchísimas gracias, Arturo. Y bueno, un día de eso usted y yo vamos a platicar, a ver cómo se me va a tranquilizar un poquitito, porque está increíble de trabajo. Pero bueno, ok, pues tenemos al señor Sergio Tamayo. Muchísimo gusto de conocerlo. Gracias por estar aquí con nosotros. Y platíquenos un poquitito de su obra y de lo que usted, cómo empezó, cómo fue que llegó a hacer este tipo de tremendo arte.
Bueno, yo heredé la gracia de mi padre de pintar. Uh-huh. Y siempre me ha traído dibujar la acuarela. De hecho, mi obra de la exposición de hoy a las 5 de la tarde, que los espero a todos, exclusivamente son obras en acuarela, cuya temática principal es el desierto y todo lo que conlleva el ambiente del desierto, que es el idioma universal entre Sonora y Arizona, que nosotros queremos fomentar ese intercambio cultural que no tiene fronteras y al contrario nos mejora como seres humanos.
Exactamente. Y veo que una de sus obras, estas son sus obras, ¿verdad? Estos
son
dos.
Tres ejemplos, okay. ¿Verdad?
So we have these two on the front and that one on the left there.
Así es.
Son sus obras y más o menos como cuánto tiempo le toma pintar una de esas, porque veo que es un detalle increíble.
Es variable, va un promedio de un mes, dos meses, depende del trabajo de cada cuadro, es muy distinto, ¿no?
Okay. Entonces, hoy va a haber una inauguración aquí en el Menke Square, ¿verdad?
Sí, empieza el día de hoy. Ajá. Y termina el 27 de febrero.
O sea, pues tenemos todo un mes,
pero vamos a tener todo este año celebrando los 15 años de Cuadro Arte Latino Internacional.
Perfecto.
Que también vamos a hablar sobre ese tema también con el maestro Bejarano, que como vamos a abrir esa celebración de este año, pero el señor Tamayo, abrimos también el año con él, con esa gran exposición individual ahí en Galería Jerónimo de Main Gate Square. Así que nos acompañen ahí, por favor, a las 5 de la tarde.
Pues vamos a estar ahí. Y a ver, señor Bejarano, gusto en conocerlo, un placer.
Igualmente.
Y un honor también, por supuesto. A ver,
gracias por la invitación.
Sí. Nada.
Vamos a iniciar el día viernes 30. Vamos a tener una exposición aquí en la calle 5 y Broadway. Uh-huh. Es una exposición que se llama Rostros y Miradas en Tucson, uh-huh. 2015.
Esta es una de sus obras,
sí,
¿verdad?
Esta es una técnica.
It is beautiful, beautiful frame. Absolutely
una técnica de pastel. Uh-huh. Es un poco es como la acuarela, es un poco difícil porque los errores a veces no se pueden
corregir
y va que tienen que ir quedando, ¿no? Ah. Pero pues ya con la experiencia, pues se trata de que salga adelante la obra.
So look at these beautiful, beautiful pieces of art, and you're right, these faces, como las caras, ¿verdad? Me decía
sí.
Caras, es
sí.
Beautiful detail in the colors, the child and the old man. Vi la del anciano, qué barbaridad. Para hacer el cabello.
El detalle. Es.
Así que por favor que nos acompañen el próximo viernes 30 de enero aquí en Barrio Cuisine, 188 al este de la Broadway, aquí en la esquina de Broadway y Quinta Avenida aquí en Tucson Downtown. Así es que acompáñenos por favor con esta gran obra maestra de estos grandes maestros del arte plástica de Sonora.
Definitivamente, Arturo, ya vamos a estar ahí. Nos vamos a ver entonces al ratito. Ahí van a estar ustedes, ¿verdad?
Pues claro,
¿y va a haber música?
Ay, por favor, hay que bailar también.
Entonces,
sí, así es que el próximo viernes, el 30 de enero, a las 5:30 de la tarde de la apertura, con el señor Bejarano, y el día de hoy, uh-huh. con el señor Tamayo, que su obra se va a quedar todo el mes, terminando enero y febrero, para que nos acompañen y vayan a visitar, por favor, la obra.
Perfecto. Y bueno, amigos, continuamos con Bienvenidos a su Casa. Y bueno, amigos, hemos llegado a uno de los segmentos más emocionantes en este programa, porque tenemos a personalidades muy importantes del Tucson Gemmel Mineral Show del 2015. Pónganse muy listos porque vamos a tener muchas sorpresas y además pues nos van a tener que acompañar a esos shows que van a estar por toda la ciudad de Tucson. Hay una página de website que les vamos a anunciar muy pronto para que ustedes vean cuándo va a estar todos los shows y las fechas, ¿ok? Thank you so much for being here with us again. We're back and we are right now with two personalities from the Tucson Gemmel Mineral Show, and you're just gonna love it, so stay here. And we're gonna be welcoming Gloria Quick. Hola, Gloria, how are you doing?
Hello, Maria, I'm doing fine.
Thank you for inviting me. Thank you for being here. She's the chair of publicity, right, for the Tucson Gemmel Mineral Show?
Yes, I'm the publicity chair.
And we have Dr. McGall. How are you? Gusten, por cierto, muy cierto, habla un perfecto español, así que hoy te lo vamos a entrevistar y van a ver todas las cosas tan interesantes que tiene para decir. Pero bueno, Gloria, you were talking to me a little bit about that you do some genealogy research. Tell me a little bit about it. How did you get to that?
I guess I was always interested in where my grandparents came from. I knew they came from Sicily, but not much more than that. Didn't know anything about their home lives. And like a lot of people, I really decided to get started after everyone who knew everything had died. So I really had to start from scratch researching my grandparents, where they were born, and how they came to the U.S. It's been really exciting because I've been able to trace at least my father's family back to the very late 1700s.
Oh, wow.
I've been able to get birth certificates, marriage certificates for at least my direct line, parent, grandparent, great-grandparent, and so forth. And on my mother's side, I've been able to trace back to the mid to early 1800s. It's fun.
What an amazing, you know, history itself is amazing and fascinating. Mm-hmm. But finding about your own family has mm-hmm. to be incredibly exciting. And I mean, you probably get
Yes. Sometimes you find some really interesting things. One thing I found about my father's family, and it kind of ties in with the show this year, is they came from a town called Delia Caltanissetta, Sicily. And Delia is known as being a sulfur mining town. Mm-hmm. And as I researched my father's family, I found that they were all sulfur miners. That was the profession that they had, that they all worked in the mines in the sulfur industry. On my mother's side, it was a little bit different. They came from a different part of Sicily. I think they were a little bit better off financially. They came from a nicer district. And one thing that surprised me, when I looked at the professions of some of the women in my mother's family, and I mean in the mid-1800s, they were property owners.
Really?
Which is something you just would not expect, especially in Sicily.
Yeah.
So it's very interesting, and it's like going on a treasure hunt every day.
Yes, it's amazing just to find out about all these things. And like you said, 1800s, you wouldn't think that there is any kind of careers or, you know, businesses at that time, but yes. There was, huh?
Yes, there really were. It was fascinating.
And I hear, and also we were talking, you and I, because we had an amazing meeting one of these days. You were talking a little bit about that you also could help some other people, like, you know, if they have any questions on where to start or how to get started.
Yes, I will sometimes conduct workshops on how to get started in genealogy. Mm-hmm. And if people are doing the work on their own and they kind of get stuck, I will offer to help them. I'm not a registered genealogist, I'm not a professional, mm-hmm. but I do have a lot of experience and I love doing it. I also like helping people because it's just as exciting to see their reactions when they find that birth certificate or that marriage record that has just stumped them for months.
It's amazing. Really, yeah, I mean, I can imagine I would really get emotional just listening to it. And I have family, and I don't know how far back I can track, but it would be so wonderful if we can get to that. And there's a lot of people very interested in that kind of subject,
yes,
right?
A lot of people are. And a lot of Mexican records are opening up now that weren't open, say, 10 years ago.
It's
making it a little bit easier to do research. I'd love to try to work on your family. I think it'll be fun.
That would be wonderful. Yes, absolutely. You tell me what you need and we'll work on that.
Okay.
Well, thank you so much, Gloria. And of course, you also are the chair of the publicity of the Tucson Gemini Minola Show. Tell us a little bit about it, and we're going to introduce also our friend here.
Yes. Well, I do the publicity for the Gem and Mineral Show. I've been doing it for about 5 years now, so I'm the one that gets the ads in the trade journals and the commercials on the TV and the radio stations. And I also arrange for TV shows like yours into the show and to videotape while we're at the show. Yeah. It's a lot of fun.
Mm-hmm.
I enjoy talking about the show. And in my opinion, one of the best aspects of our show compared to everyone else's is that we bring in exhibits. And the person responsible for bringing all of those great exhibits is my friend, Dr. Peter McGaw.
So, tell us a little bit about it.
¿Qué quieres saber? Este año tenemos una serie de exhibiciones de todo el mundo. El tema este año es minerales del parte poniente de Europa, que es decir, todo que es al poniente del límite poniente de Rusia.